Okay.
We were looking at vectors last time. We looked at some summation or resultants for vectors, right? There is no division or multiplication defined for vectors. So we looked at dot product and cross product. Doing all right?
Yes.
What we're going to look at is triple products. Okay? There are two triple products. We have a vector triple product. Vector triple product, you have A cross B cross C, which is equal to the way you should remember this is A, B, C, okay? A cross B cross C is equal to back minus cap. You see back minus cap?
Yes.
The only thing you have to keep in mind is back, this is, there's a dot here, cap is a dot here, okay? It is back minus cap. Realize that, why is it called a vector triple product? The outcome of this is a vector. Okay. What is the outcome of a dot product? It's a scalar. So this, the outcome is a vector, if you see. So the vector is, this is one vector, this is another vector. So essentially you are subtracting one vector from another. So you are going to get another vector. And you have to remember that A cross B cross C is not equal to A cross B cross C. Okay. The next one is a scalar triple product. So scalar triple product, what do you want to do is A dotted with B cross C is equal to these are identities. So what you have to notice here is you realize that this is the outcome is a scalar. What is the cross product of two vectors? The cross product of two vectors, what does it result in? It results in a vector, in another vector, right? So this results in another vector, and if you dot it with a vector, it's a scalar. So this is a scalar. That is the reason it's called a scalar triple product. And it's called triple because there are three vectors in it. And we have to look at this. This is what you're trying to do here is this is an identity. You're doing a cyclic rotation. Cyclic rotation means your A has gone here. Right? C has moved to the second position and B has moved to the first position. So it's cyclic, it's a cyclic rotation. You see that? Here also it's a cyclic rotation. So cyclically, if you move, it will be the same. You may need to use this identity. That's the reason we are discussing this. In general, keep this in mind. A dot B is always equal to B dot A. But A cross B is equal to minus B cross A. It is not equal to B cross A. B cross B is not equal to B cross A. It is minus B cross A.
So the scalar triple product of position of the vectors means we need to be pretty simple, right?
Say that again?
So it's important the location of the vector in the scalar triple product.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Let's discuss a little bit of kinematics. So you'll get a real nice understanding of what kinematics is. Generally, you go by the definition that kinematics does not involve forces, right? But you'll understand it here. Let's say you have a position vector r, okay, the coordinate k. The Cartesian coordinate system is ijk. And you have, let's say this is the velocity, this is the acceleration. So if you denote R, R is equal to x of E I plus y of E V of E. What is the magnitude of R? How do you define the magnitude of R?
Square root of
right. Square root of you realize the difference between x and x of p?
Yes.
Everyone?
No.
Right, this is a time dependent variable. We are, in most cases, we are going to talk about time dependent variable. Okay, here R is a time dependent variable. Okay. I may not use this T explicitly, but if I do use it, it's just for your convenience. Most cases it will be time dependent variable. It's just, if it's just a constant, then it won't be. I'll specifically mention that. Yes, sir.
Time dependent variable as a function. So that's what A was just saying. I like that.
Yeah.
Okay. We need some alcohol for that.
Yeah. So keep in mind, you have to understand time dependent variables. You cannot really proceed without understanding time dependent variable. Okay? So this is how you define the magnitude.
Question.
Now
I have a question. Could you go over what you mean by time dependent variable?
Time dependent variable.
Like, you know, like I understand the general understanding of it, mm-hmm. but your understanding of it slightly.
You have to understand. As we go forward, you'll understand. This is something you should know by now.
Yeah, I mean, I know, but yeah. I understand yours might be different than mine.
It's a time dependent variable, the variable which changes with time. For example, if you're driving in a car, your position is changing, right?
Right.
Your position is a function of time. It's dependent on time.
Okay.
Mr. Johnson, you'll be reported to the head of department today. I'll report to the head of department. Yes. Because I have been telling you many times.
Did you say the health department?
Head of department. Okay. I'm going to report it to Ms. Tenson and head of department. And let them take care of it. So, position. If position changes, rate of change of position is?
Velocity.
Rate of change of velocity is?
Acceleration,
right? So, if position keeps changing, you get velocity. So, it's a time dependent variable. If position is not changing, then it's a constant.
Okay.
For example, if this, the position of this particular this thing is always here with respect to, let's say, this quadrant system, mm-hmm. z, x, y, right? It's a constant. And if I change it, if I move it around as position of time, it's a time dependent. For example, your position. It's a time dependent variable. It changes, right? With respect to this quadrant system.
No, it changes.
Huh? Keep, you sit here all the time?
It's not
there,
Andrew.
Alright. So how do you define velocity? Velocity is?
dt.
dt of?
Position.
Position. Okay. You have v over dt of x of t I plus b over dt of y t over t. Keep this in mind. Now, this is assuming the coordinate basis itself is not going to change. Right? You understand what I mean by the coordinate basis itself is not going to change?
Mm-hmm.
We look at Newton's laws, but you should know by now that Newton's laws are applicable only in an inertial coordinate system.